So one day, I was performing one of my favorite activities, scrolling through old Disney patents. And I came across this one specifically. Artificial eye with internal electromagnetic drive. Now after reading it for a second, and looking at the pictures, I figured, wow, that looks really cool and super duper doable. So that's what we're going to make today in this video. So what is an artificial eye with internal electromagnetic drive? Well, to understand this, we first have to look at how normal animatronic eyes work. And what that is you have your eye, and then behind that you have servos, about six of them. Because you need servos to turn the eye and blink, and servos to turn the other eye. So, what this patent describes is a method of embedding electromagnets directly into the eye, so you don't need the servos out behind. This is a good thing, because, well, A, it's a lot quieter, because servos are loud, moving their gears around and then all that, that's really loud. B, it should be a lot smaller, if you imagine you want to have as much space in a human head as possible. And with this, you have a lot more space. And C, well, I just thought it'd be really cool to have an internally driven electromagnetic eye. Since this eye is entirely driven by electromagnets, let's look at how we're going to make those electromagnets. So in a previous video, I made one with plastic cores. That's not the best, because the way electromagnets work, they are much better with a ferromagnetic material like iron nails. So, for the electromagnets inside this eye, I'm going to use these nails. But of course, if you imagine the size of a human eye or even a ping pong ball, there's no way you're fitting enough electromagnets to drive it around. We actually need 8 electromagnets. So what we need to do is cut these down. Considering I was going for a centimeter, I'd say just about nailed that one. Alright, I've got all the nails cut. They're all about a centimeter. Some are a little long, but that's okay. I made way too many just because I knew something might go wrong. And to help wind them, I created this little jig. Alright, so the jig I made here works like this. The screw goes in and sticks out about 5 millimeters. Then I tighten down this grub screw here to hold it in place. Then I take the copper wire, and there's a little channel right on top. You slide it through that, if I can get it. All right, I got it. And then you give yourself a nice long lead. Take the copper wire, and you just start coiling. 200. All right, so I've given it 200 coin turns. And now to hold it in place, I'm going to grab a little bit of super glue. Where'd the super glue go? Alright, so it's super glue and held in place. Now we have a 200 turn electromagnet right there. Alright, let's look at the CAD model then. So there are 3 main parts, the outer eye, the post here, and the inner eye. So the outer eye is the part you'll actually see. That's the part that'll move around. And it is connected to the gimbal post with a revolution, so a joint that can turn. And that is connected via a M2 screw. And if we look at it, you can see it turns this way. Then the post is connected to the inner eye by another joint, which is another M3 screw, and it turns the outer eye this way. Then if we take a closer look at the inner eye, we can see that there are these holes here for the electromagnets to go in. There's 8 electromagnets. And the channels here are for the wires to come out. The electromagnets are evenly spaced around the sphere. And then right here you can see another little divot, and that is for the homing magnet. So the 4 electromagnets that go inside the ring here get recentered by the homing magnet here. And what that does is it allows you to have all the electromagnets off and the eye looking dead straight. Alright, so I've gone ahead and printed the eye and built the electromagnets and glued them in, and I've assembled it, but I think there's a slight problem in that the magnets on the gimbal on the outer eye are attracted to the nails that the electromagnets are wound on, and that homing magnet in the front that I talked about does absolutely nothing, and applying a current to that does absolutely nothing. So I think what I'm going to try next is, instead of permanent magnets, use ferromagnets like the nails, so the permanent magnet still tracks them, and the electromagnet still tracks them, but just the nails themselves don't. Alright, so I've gone ahead and replaced those permanent magnets in the gimbal ring with ferromagnets in the form of nails, and now it's too weak to respond to the homing magnet's forces at all. So from here, I think the plan is to put the permanent magnets back in, but remake the inner eye with non-ferro cord or iron cord electromagnets. Alright, so I've gone ahead and made a new eye with these plastic posts. And let me tell you, making these plastic posts was not nearly as fun as making these nail posts. So taking a closer look at the eye, the homing magnet works now. So you can see that always returns to center. If it is a little wobbly, that's okay. So all that's left now is checking out how running current through the electromagnet affects the rings. So I have 4 of the electromagnets set up so that when the voltage run through by the power supply, the ring will pull backwards like this. So as I turn on the power supply, I give it 2 volts, that's about 1 amp running through the 4 coils, and it pulls the ring backwards here. Then if I turn off the power, the homing magnet brings it back towards center. And turn the power back on, it just goes right back. Now there is a slight problem of, it's really far away, like the eye is really big, it's about twice the size of an actual human eye, which means sometimes the electromagnets don't actually have enough pull to pull on the permanent magnets in the ring. So I think what I'm going to do is, before the next video, I'm going to make a smaller version, so it's more human-sized and it works better. And then we'll look at how I'm going to proportionally control it so it can look like slightly to the right and slightly down or anything like that. So make sure you're subscribed to see the next part of this eye and all my other future products. Hit the bell icon so they actually notify you. And see you next time.